Night falls over Sarajevo, covering the scars of war. It's Ramadan in this mostly Muslim city, and sunset signals it's time to break the daily fast and to pray. During the war, Islamic religious leaders tried to protect Bosnia's rape victims. They told their communities such women should be supported, their children embraced.
First is that a woman who survived war rape is not guilty, but she is like a shahid, like a hero who is killed on the God's road. So she is at the level of heroine. And that child born out of rape is born from a side of Muslim and will be member of Islamic and Muslim community, will be considered as a Muslim child and upbring as a Muslim child. So it helps a lot in Bosnian community.
Preživjeti te traume, ne samo silovanje, nego preživjeti traume kad dođeš na područje, slobodno područje, gdje možeš naići na osudu da si, da u mentalitetu ljudi je tako, na osudu što si dozvolila da te siluju ili što ćeš roditi srpsko dijete i slično, to je veliki problem.
Jasmina became pregnant after being raped by a Croatian soldier.
Pa kad sam saznala sam trudna, bilo jedino mi je bilo riješiti se trudnoće. Znala sam da će me podsjećati, znala sam da će... Pa sam osjećala mržnju jednostavno, mržnju, onda sam... No, ja sam osjećala da sam mogla uzeti jednostavno nulu, da se isparam stomak, da... Svašta, svašta. Ovdje kad sam došla na pregled, prvi put kad smo je pregledali, rekla mi je doktorca da je žensko. Možda je to jedini, ili možda je ovo sigurno jedini u onoj znak da je zadrži, što je žensko.
Going through with the pregnancy brought Jasmina more pain.
Kad je meni bila mala, na meni dođe, mama, šta je kopila? Zašto mene zovu kopila? Zašto sam ja kopila? Zašto nije ona, recimo, njena drugarca kopila, nije drug, zašto ona?
She loves her daughter, but there are moments when the past comes rushing back.
Facu, kad napravi facu me i dan danas. Toliko me pogodi nekad biti. Da nekako prevaziđem ili zapalim ili zađem na moment. Na to je samo sekunde.
All the rape mothers are troubled by this question of what to tell their children and when.
Ona je jako vizana uz mene i onaj... Mi imamo tajni, ja je učim toliko da jednostavno da ne imamo tajni, jer ja još djetetu nikad nisam ispričala ništa nikako. Sve mi je žao iz godine u godinu, sve mi je više žao da je povrijedim, da sazna, da mislim da će mi ta trebati možda i stručna pomoć ili neko, ne znam kako će mi djete ne reagovati na to.
In a majority of cases, they are telling their children that their fathers are killed in the war. They do not want to expose their children. They don't want that their children has a feeling that they are different from the other children. We advise them to tell children when children will be mature enough to bear the fact.
Some fear their child's rejection when they finally tell them the truth.
Žao mi djete povrijedi, ja nje sad pričam, da, ja znam koliko će nju povrijediti. Ali je pripremala s tim što je vežem puno za sebe, da mi vjeruje, da me prije svega voli, da bi mi mogla oprostiti.
The risk of them being told by strangers increases once they reach school age. And that's what happened to Alan, now 13.
Vraćali smo se u auto I on mene pita, kaže, babo, rekao mu, ovaj jedan komšija, dječak, njegov vršnjak, kaže da te vi mene niste rodili, da nisam vaše dijete, da njega njegova majka bacila u kontiner, na kantu za smeće.
Alan has lived with his adoptive family since being abandoned at birth. His dad has told him what he could about his birth mother.
Pa on zna da je silovan od strane srpskog vojnika, gore ufa, ne znam niko ko je šta je. Majka je to bila zarobljena I ona je silovana, niko ne zna, ne znamo ni mi, čak ni ja ne znam, ja što sam zna, ja sam mu rekao. Rekao sam mu istinu kako ga je majka rodila u bolnici u Goraždu, ostavila ga dva sata, bila jer ja sam tada radio u bolnici. To je spontano došlo, tako da je ona njega rodila, nije čak htjela da ga podoji, samo rodila I čim se malo porodila, pobjegla.
Da li imaš želju da pronađeš...
So is Alan still curious, does he want to find his mother?
Pa za sad nemam, ali u stvari neću nikad imati. Mislim, sad imam svoje roditelje I ono, nikako I ne razmišljam o tome.
Hoćeš mi ga pokazati?
Nije snimljen.
Zar nije?
Još nije.
Alan's life has been made into a film. Its director, Semsudin Gegic, wanting to break the subject's taboo.
I strašan krik da se to više ne događa.
As Bosnian society's failure to accept them could sow the seeds of another war.
Ako to država ne prizna I ne kaže da postoje ta djeca, to će se nama ponoviti za narednih 10-20 godina.
Alan is clearly close to his adoptive father. Already bright and inquisitive, the love Alan receives has given him confidence even in his difference. Ten years after the war, Bosnians are still in denial about these children. And many of their rapist fathers are walking free.
Prema tome treba donijeti zakon, reći postoje ta djeca, to se dogodilo, oni koji su to učinili da idu na sud, da idu u zatvor, a oni koji su prihvatili tu djecu treba da dobiju stimulaciju I treba da dobiju podršku da bi ta djeca imala svoju budućnost.
These children have great potential, but as they mature, their search for identity will create some difficult days ahead.